the Lord, everybody. Amen. Praise the Lord, somebody. Come on, let's give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you for coming to church. Good to see you. Turn around, give somebody a big thumbs up. Good to see you this morning. Thank you for coming to the house of God. Come on, folks, let's worship God. Hallelujah. Whatever comes our way, we can't let it stop us from worshiping God. Hallelujah. We got to magnify him. We got to lift him up. We got to give him the praise that is due unto his name. Praise God. If we'll praise him, he'll see us through this. If we'll lift him up, he'll see us through this. Praise God. Hallelujah. If we praise him, there'll be an end to this thing somewhere in the near future. Hallelujah. And we can get back to having church the way we desire to this morning. Hallelujah. Worship God this morning as they come and lead us in our singing. Magnify the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. One more time, give the Lord a great big hand clap of praise this morning.
Oh, let revival come. you, Jesus. God, let revival fall in this place today.
Yeah. Lift up our hands and begin to love the Lord for all of his wonderful countless blessings. He woke us up this morning in our right mind. He put shoes on our feet and food on our table. Lord, I'm so humbled, God, by all that you've done in my life, God. There are many times, God, that you could have just given up on me. All the chances that you've given me, Lord, God, I'm so thankful for them, God. I wouldn't be here, God, if it wasn't for you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for your wonderful blessings, God. The Lord is my shepherd. He goes before me. He's the defender. Defender behind me. I won't fear.
Say he always got guides me. He always guides me.
Through the mountains.
Through mountains and valleys.
And His joy is refreshing.
His joy is refreshing.
And it restores my soul.
Restores my soul.
Sing it with our whole heart and our whole mind. Sing hallelujah. Time, let's all sing it together as strong as we can. Oh, hallelujah, I am not alone. Thank you, Jesus. You are our comfort, God. He's my comfort. Always holds me close. One more time. Let's sing it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I am not alone.
'Cause He's my comfort.
He's my comfort.
He's here to comfort us this morning in our despair, in our sickness, in our hardships. Amen. In these things that we're facing now as a church, as a society. Hallelujah. He is here to comfort us this morning. Praise God. That's what the Holy Ghost does. He is a comforter. Praise God. Hallelujah. So the list of prayer requests that have come into this church are so long, so many names, so many people. Hallelujah. It just does not behoove us to go down that long list of names. Churches, preachers, pastors, amen, all across the Southeast and all across America that are sick, amen, and needing our prayers. They're going to put the names on our screen of those that have called and ask us to add them to our list of names on the screen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I want you to lift your hands right now in understanding that God knows what every prayer request is, that God knows that people have called this church for prayer. Hallelujah. Even though some asked to not even be put on the screen. Praise God. They just wanted us to pray. Hallelujah. I wonder this morning if you would join together with me in prayer. Amen. For the sick, for the shut-ins, for those that are not able to get out and about and come to church this morning. Hallelujah. Could we pray together for them along with the names on our screen this morning? Hallelujah. Father, this morning, God, we come before your throne of grace. God, thanking you, God, that you are our comforter, God. Thanking you, God, that you are our very present help in time of need, God. Lord, there's so many needs in the land, so many people that have called us for prayer, so many people, hallelujah, that have various needs, God, that, hallelujah, only you can take care of, God, and only, amen, you are big enough and strong enough and wise enough, amen, to help these people with the issues that they have this morning, God. But, Lord, we're praying for them, and we are agreeing with them, God, hallelujah, as touching their needs, God, hallelujah. Lord, we agree, God, with every person that called us and asked us to add their name to our list, God. We are agreeing, God, hallelujah, with these precious people, amen, on our screen this morning, God, hallelujah. Some of them need healing. Some of them need a miracle. Some of them need a job. Some of them need salvation, God, hallelujah. Some of them need deliverance, God. Hallelujah, from the snares of the enemy, God. God, we're praying, God, for everyone listed on our screen here, God. Hallelujah, that you would be their Savior, that you would be their healer, that you would be their deliverer, God, today. Hallelujah. Oh, today I'm my shine, today I'm my God, today I'm my shine, God. Hallelujah, we are praying, God. Hallelujah, Lord, for any need that may be in the house this morning, God. Lord, you see the people inside of this sanctuary right now, that, God, that are hurting. God, you see the people inside of this sanctuary right now, God, that are suffering pain in their body. Hallelujah, God, while we're praying for others, God, we will not neglect our own congregation. Hallelujah, God, these are your people. This is your church. Hallelujah. This congregation has needs today. Oh, God, we feel your presence here right now. Come on, if you need a healing touch, God, just raise your hand right now and ask him for it. Hallelujah. If you need a miracle, why don't you just raise your hand right now and receive it. Receive it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us be encouraged today, God. what we see in the house, by what we feel in the house, God. Lord, of a certainty this morning, you have not forsaken us. You have not deserted us. You have not left us. You're here right now, God. Come on. Come on, somebody, lift your hand one more time. An ounce of power. He hadn't lost any strength. Amen. He's still God. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's still God this morning. Praise God. He's still God. Hallelujah. He's a God that's on the throne. Hallelujah. Isaiah saw his train filling the temple. Hallelujah. That train represented the anointing of God filling the temple, filling the temple, filling the temple. Praise God. If you'd have been around here last night as I was fogging this building, praise God, hallelujah, I was walking around this sanctuary fogging the building with that disinfectant, praise God, and after just a little while with the doors shut and everything kind of closed off, man, hallelujah, I just imagine. I know it was a figment. I just imagined, amen, hallelujah, if we could actually see into the spirit realm this morning, hallelujah, amen, when the glory of God comes down, amen, in the house, hallelujah, amen, I could just see it as that great fog, amen, covered this sanctuary last night, amen, hallelujah, amen, a place where you and I, amen, could be caught up together, amen, in the heavens, hallelujah, amen, 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 to have our audience with God. He said in his word that he would cause us, somebody lift your hand and say that's me, he would cause us to sit together in heavenly places with him. Hallelujah. He would cause us, amen, to sit in heavenly places with him. Well, if you hadn't felt heaven yet, I don't know what your problem is, because heaven is in the house. Heaven and earth. Heaven and earth. Heaven and earth is coming together in this house this morning. Praise God. Oh, come on, I think God deserves another hand clap of praise. She's walking into the throne room. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Heaven, amen, even been called for. Hallelujah, but there she shows herself in the throne room. Amen, and she looks at the throne where the king is sitting. Amen, and all of a sudden with a smile on his face, he reaches down and grabs that scepter, and he reaches out to her, which says to her, amen, Esther, you are welcomed, amen, in this throne room this morning. Hallelujah. I feel like God is saying amen to us. Hallelujah. Oh, we are welcome in the house. We are welcome in the throne room. We are welcome here today. Hallelujah. Woo! I feel the little goosebumps running up down my spine right now. I don't know what to do with what I'm feeling right now. Hallelujah. I'm feeling them little goose pimples, them little, amen, them little, whatever you call them, hallelujah. Amen, they run up and down your spine when the power of the Holy Ghost is in the house. Woo, hallelujah. Yay, God. And the promises of God are yay and amen in Him. Oh, Jesus. Amen. The devil's trying to keep us from having church. Amen. But I thank God for everybody that came in here this morning. Amen. With a made up mind, I'm going to have church today. Hallelujah. I'm going to have church today. I'm going to have church today. Hallelujah. I'm going to sing. I'm going to dance. I'm going to run an aisle or two. I'm going to worship my God. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God. Oh, God. Hallelujah, my shine. Yodadiyah, my shine. Nadadiyah, my kadadiyah, my shine. Hallelujah. 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 I feel the Lord saying, come unto me, all ye that are laden and heavy burdened. Praise God. Come unto me. Come unto me, and I'll give you rest. Hallelujah, there's rest for the weary in the house of God. There's rest, hallelujah, from your struggles in the house of God this morning. Hallelujah. Amen. Come unto me and I'll give you rest. Hallelujah. I want to say to all of you that, amen, would normally be up here in a prayer line and we'd be out there laying hands on everybody. Amen. Praying with you and crying with you and hallelujah and working with you in that manner. Hallelujah. But for the time being, with all of this stuff going on, I guess we need to kind of refrain ourselves in some way or another. But I want to say to you, that if you need contact with something or somebody, hallelujah, to build your faith in God to where it needs to be, to where you can receive what you need in God. We have anointed a lot of prayer cloths. Amen. The prayer cloths are in our visitor center back there in the back. So as you leave today, if you need a prayer cloth, an anointed prayer cloth, as a point of contact, as a point of contact, hallelujah, amen, then feel free to pick up one of those prayer cloths and take it with you. Take it out of the little plastic bag that it's in. Amen. Put it in your billfold if you need a financial blessing. Amen. Put it in your clothing. Amen. If you need healing in your body, hallelujah. Put it in your automobile if you need a new automobile, hallelujah. Amen. Tape it to your vacuum cleaner if you need a new vacuum cleaner. Amen. It don't matter what you need. Prayer and prayer calls work. Amen. So don't hesitate. Don't hesitate, amen, to get a prayer cloth when you leave here today. Turn around, look at somebody, and give them a great big thumbs up. By giving them that, you're saying thank you for coming to church today. It's good to see you in the house of God. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. No, they're not here. Brother James is a burden right now for Brother and Sister Weber. Want to pray for them right now. He feels a burden in his heart for them. So could you, amen, could you close your eyes, lift your hand to God right now? Lord, you know the need. God, you know the burden that you placed on Brother James' heart this morning for Brother and Sister Weber. You know what they're facing. You know what they're going through. You know what's happening in their little world right now, God. Hallelujah. So we agree together with this congregation. Hallelujah, God, Lord, and we believe, God, that you're going to touch Brother and Sister Weber in Jesus' name, God, that you're going to touch them, that you're going to lift them up, that you're going to give strength and healing to them, God, if that's what they need, God. I don't know what they may need right now, God, but, Lord, you know all things, God, so we agree right now, hallelujah, agree right now, God, hallelujah. Oh, God, that you're going to touch Brother and Sister Weber right now in Jesus' name, we ask it, praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I wonder if we could give the Lord one more hand clap of praise. Thank you, Jesus. He is a prayer answering God this morning. Prayer answering God. I'm not going to repeat the talk that we had last Sunday. That's behind us. We're going to go on, amen, and have church the best way that we know how, and to keep everybody safe in the process. Amen, and just do the best that we can with this thing. Praise God. I do want to remind everybody that we will not be taking up offerings, amen, here with the men coming through the auditorium. There is a tithing and offering box at the back door when you leave. Amen, if you would kindly put your tithing and offering in that box. Praise God. Well, kind of challenged, I guess, a little bit. Not challenged, that's not the word that I needed. I was asked, amen, to redo our seating situation in the auditorium here, to redo it, amen, and actually block off the front row and then start people sitting in the second row and then skip a row, third row, skip a row. And, you know, when I was asked to do that, I kind of felt like that if I did that, that would be an indictment against us as a church. Amen. That nobody at Higher Praise Tabernacle wants to sit on the front row. But you know what? Amen. Look at here. We got a front row full of seats. Oh, we got people, amen, sitting on the front row over here. We got people sitting on the front row over here. Amen. So everybody's not scared to sit on the front row. Thank you, Brother and Sister Row. Thank you, Brother James. Thank you, Sister Rel, Sister Bertha. A front row saint of God now. Hallelujah. thank you for coming this morning and being willing and ready to sit on the front row. Praise God. All right. Well, I don't know what else to do here this morning. We've sung, we've worshiped, we've praised God, we felt the power of God. Hallelujah. So I guess it's time, amen, to preach. We are going to try to incorporate anybody that would like to sing a special. If you're here and you sing by yourself, or you sing a special or whatever, in absence of being able to sing the choir right now, we would like to maybe insert a special song from individuals that would like to sing, amen, occasionally in our services. And so if you sing a special and you want to sing, then we just let us know and we'll make room for you in the service and singing a special. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. In 1 Chronicles chapter 11. Last Sunday, I got up to preach, and just right before I got up to preach, I got a scratch in my throat and started coughing. I'm scared. I'm sure I put the fear of something in everybody. Now, this morning, my throat is beginning to scratch again. Praise God. So would you pray for my throat right now that God would give me, that God would give me, can I have a little more monitor, Brother Rick? Maybe that'll help me from feeling like I need to to really scream and holler or whatever. Just give me a little more monitor and help me to preserve my voice this morning. Praise God. Do you love the Lord? I know you do. You're here. You're here on Sunday morning. Hallelujah. People are starting to come back a little at a time, and we're so grateful for this good crowd that is here. Amen. This Sunday morning. 1 Chronicles chapter 11, verse 7 through verse 10. And David dwelt in the castle. Therefore, they called it the city of David, Jerusalem, the city of David. And he built the city around about, even from Milo around about. And Joab repaired the rest of the city. And David waxed greater and greater, for the Lord of hosts was with him. These also are the chief of the mighty men whom David had, who strengthened themselves with him in his kingdom and with all of Israel to make him king according to the word of the Lord concerning Israel. Praise God. You can be seated this morning. Four little verses of scripture here about King David. Amen. Conquering and capturing the city of Jerusalem, repairing the city after it was captured, praise God, and him living in the castle, praise God, hallelujah. Then verse 10 tells us that they were mighty men whom David had, who strengthened themselves with him in his kingdom, praise God, hallelujah. In verse 11 through verse 47 of chapter 11, amen, there are listed by name, 37 mighty men of valor, whom the Bible says who strengthened themselves alongside of David as he waxed greater and greater, for the Lord was with him. Praise God. Now, this list of names that I'm not going to take time to read to you this morning, I'm sure you've read them before. Hallelujah. And if you hadn't taken time to read them, you need to go back and take time to read the names of these mighty men of valor. Praise God. All of this record of mighty men that is listed there in the Word of God, amen, is referred to as the catalog of mighty men. Catalog of mighty men. The word catalog is not a biblical word, amen, but it simply means a list, a list. The word catalog means a list of men of valor. Praise God. is recorded in the Word of God. Hallelujah. Name after name after name after name. 37 in all, praise God, of men of valor that served, amen, David in his kingship. Praise God. The word valor in Hebrew is spelled C-H-A-Y-I-L, or that's what it's translated in English to, and I cannot pronounce that word. Amen. So I'll just leave it at that. Praise God. But valor, the word valor means a force. Somebody say that with me, a force. Men of valor, a force. Praise God. In this case, it means a band of strong soldiers who are war-tested and worthy, amen, to be added to this list. Hallelujah. A band of soldiers who are war-tested and worthy to be there and to be on this list. Praise God. We refer to our military today as our military what? Our military forces. That didn't start with, amen, the military forces of America. Amen. It started way back whenever militaries were arranged and put together. Hallelujah. Amen. So we could say, amen, today that these men were David's special forces. Special forces. Praise God. Men who are trained in warfare. Hallelujah. Verse 10 says that these men strengthened themselves with him. Praise God. Amen. Who strengthened themselves with him in his kingdom. Hallelujah. Now, how did they do that? How did all of these mighty men, amen, strengthen themselves with David? Hallelujah. How did they do that? Amen. They didn't. Well, these particular men, they didn't stop with just basic training. Hallelujah. I think our military sends men to like 6 weeks, or they used to at least. They'd send a man that was going to in the military to a 6 weeks basic training. Amen. They had to go in there for 6 weeks. They had to be trained what to do and how to do. Amen. When they were on the battlefield. Praise God. Hallelujah. But these men, I don't know if David had a basic training, amen, program set in order of his day. But if he did, these men didn't stop with basic training. Hallelujah. They constantly, amen, was training. They were constantly training. And I would like to say they were constantly training alongside of David. They were strengthening themselves with David. I believe they were training together. I believe David went out there and trained with them. Praise God. Why do you say that, Brother Morrell? Because David wasn't just a king. He was a military king. He wasn't just a king. He wasn't just somebody sitting on a throne, amen, dictating what went on in his, amen, little kingdom there. No, David was a military king, amen, which meant that he led his men into battle. Hallelujah. He led his men into battle after battle after battle. He was on the forefront. He was on the front lines. He was the forerunner, amen, of these men as they went into battle. Praise God. Hallelujah. So, amen, how did David come about this list? How did David come about this list of mighty men? Praise God. You know, because he was in the battle along beside of them. And when a battle was raging around him, David just couldn't stand and watch his men and witness what they did on the battlefield. He couldn't just stand and observe, amen, these men to see what they done on the battlefield. Amen. And certainly men of valor, amen, don't come home bragging about what they had done on the battlefield. So I'm sure that others that were on the battlefield, amen, witnessed these mighty men in battle and came back and reported the things that they saw on the battlefield. Praise God. I'm sure they came back, Amen. As they watch these men, amen, fight, amen, the good fight, praise God, fight, amen, the fight of warfare, hallelujah. I'm sure that they came back and they told their stories of what they saw these men do on the battlefield, hallelujah. So, amen, it wasn't just the bragging, amen, of the men of valor that got them their reputation. It was what was witnessed by others on the battlefield, reporting what they had seen. Hallelujah. Amen. In the process of hearing, amen, these reports come back, amen, from the battlefield. Eyewitnesses, amen, seeing these men of valor do what they did on the battlefield. Amen. David learned to trust these men. Report after report after report. David learned to trust these men, and they became his special forces. Praise God. These are not the only men of valor that is mentioned in the Word of God. In fact, look it up for yourself. You go look up the word valor in, amen, your concordance, praise God. And it'll start in the book of Joshua, and it will end in the book of Nehemiah. Amen. But every time the word valor is used, and is used 36 times, amen, in the Word of God, the word valor is used 36 times in the Bible. And every single time that it's used, from Joshua to Nehemiah, it refers, amen, to men, mighty men of valor. Hallelujah. Mighty men of valor. It don't just talk about valor. It talks about mighty men of valor in almost every one of those scriptures. Hallelujah. Which means, amen, to me, that each generation, amen, had their men of valor, had their forces that had to be reckoned with by the enemy. Each generation. It wasn't just David that had mighty men of valor. Joshua had mighty men of valor. And every generation after him, all the way to Nehemiah, the Bible mentions 36 times, amen, in each one of these books, hallelujah, that they were mighty men of valor. Now, praise God, sister. Now, after all of this buildup, this morning, about mighty men of valor. And I'm sure that some of you are so sure that you know where I'm headed with this. I'm sure you, my little spiel here about mighty men of valor, praise God, David's special forces, I'm sure that you've kind of got it figured out where I'm headed with this. But I don't think so this morning. I don't think you do this morning. Not today. Not today. Maybe on any other day, but not today. Hallelujah. Because I want to give my message a little title here. Praise God. Hallelujah. And it might not be what you expect it to be. Sis, if you could throw the title. Praise God. The title of my message on the screen. Hallelujah. I'm preaching about a catalog of cowards this morning. Hallelujah. Well, how can you do that after reading all of these scriptures about mighty men of valor? Hallelujah. Well, amen, sometimes when I, amen, am thinking and I'm concentrating and I'm studying and I'm trying, amen, to apply some sense to what the Word of God, amen, is saying to me. Hallelujah. There's a lot of times, amen, that the Scripture deals, amen, with one side of an issue. Hallelujah. But it doesn't really deal with the other side of a lot of issues. And, amen, as I thought about it and I contemplated it and I put thought into what I needed to say here this morning. Hallelujah. I had to begin thinking outside of the box just a little bit. Praise God. Hallelujah. And this morning I want to say to you that if David knew and David listed for our benefit and his own benefit, amen, 37 men of valor, if he listed it so it could be recorded in the Word of God, hallelujah, don't we think, or shouldn't we think this morning, hallelujah, that David, the military genius that he was, don't we think that he also knew the names of the cowards in his army. If David took it to heart to know the mighty men of valor and list them, I can assure you this morning, amen, that David knew the names, amen, of the cowards that were among his army. Hallelujah. Amen. If he knew the men that he could trust, then certainly, and I promise you, amen, that he knew the men that he could not trust. Amen. Now, there may not be a list of these, amen, catalog of cowards, amen, for us to look at their names and examine them and think about them and the great, amen, feats that these cowards did. Hallelujah. Like they are for the mighty men of valor. There's no list in the Word of God for us to examine. Amen. There is no David's catalog of cowards. But let's examine exactly what a coward is. Hallelujah. I have a 1828 Noah Webster's Dictionary, thanks to Brother Haley. Brother Haley, if you're looking or watching online, thank you for that Noah Webster's 1828 dictionary. You can go in there and define words, and they're defined, amen, quite differently than they are today in the new dictionaries. Praise God. Hallelujah. Maybe you may need to get your hands on one yourself. Hallelujah. Amen. But Noah's Webster's dictionary, 1828 version, amen, it says the word coward is a French word that means to turn the tail. Now, I can say that and not cuss, right? Turn the tail. It is a term that we use, amen, whenever we are describing a coward. Amen. We like to say they tuck tail and run. They tuck tail and ran. Hallelujah. Amen. But it's a French word, praise God, and it means to turn the tail. Hallelujah. Amen. And we use it even today. In heraldry, amen, which also confirms that the word means what Webster says it means. Hallelujah. In heraldry, it is a word or a term given to a lion born, amen, with his tail double between his legs. In heraldry. Heraldry is, amen, a nation's royal banner or a nation's coat of arms. Hallelujah. Amen. So there's many nations, many nations, hallelujah, that have a part of their coat of arms. Hallelujah. I think Great Britain does, and France does, and Israel does. Amen. Their coat of arms, amen, is represented by a lion. Amen. Throw that picture on the screen. This is at least one of the coat of arms, amen, that Israel uses over their nation. Hallelujah. Amen. So here's a coat of arms that represents Israel. Amen. It is a lion. Hallelujah. Amen. But you see the lion. Amen. His tail is standing, amen, up in the air. Hallelujah. His tail is standing. And, amen, in my thinking of this, amen, the nation of Israel is the only nation that should have a lion as their coat of arms, because they were serving the lion of the tribe of Judah. Amen. They were serving God. But listen, amen, and let me tell you a little story here. Since the 7th century, many countries, hallelujah, have royal banners or coats of arms, amen, that were depicted with lions. Amen, because the lion is supposed to be the king of the beast. Amen, that's why these nations choose the lion as their coat of arms, amen, representing that they are the king. Amen, they are superior, they are stronger, they are mightier, they are better. Hallelujah. So all of these nations today, and there are many of them, that depict their coat of arms with a lion. Hallelujah. But in jest, J-E-S-T. I want you to know what I'm saying. But in jest, Emperor Frederick, back, I believe the story said in the 12th century, I may not have that just right, but Emperor Frederick conquered the Bohemians. And in jest, he created for them a coat of arms. And he sent it down to, amen, the Bohemian king. They had conquered them. They had defeated them. So he sent them down a coat of arms. Amen. And that coat of arms was depicted with a lion with two tails tucked between its legs, indicating, amen, King Frederick or Emperor Frederick thought about the Bohemians. Hallelujah. What was he saying to them? Not only did he think that they were cowards, amen, but they were double-barrel cowards. Hallelujah. With a lion with two tails stuck between its legs. Praise God. So, amen, a lack of courage to face danger is what a coward really is. Someone with a lack of courage to face danger. David knew the men who didn't train along with his 37 men of valor. David knew the men who didn't try, amen, to train to be the best soldiers that they could be on the battlefield. He knew who they were. He knew how to identify them. Praise God. He knew the men who hung back, amen, in the back of the army. Hallelujah. He knew when they went to battle, those that were on the front lines and those men that hung out on the back lines. He knew them. He knew their names. He knew who they were. He knew where they lived. Hallelujah. He knew that those on the back lines were ready to run. Amen. Ready to run if it didn't seem to be going good on the front lines. He knew the men who were ready to desert at a moment's notice. I found 259 antonyms to the word mighty. Mighty, 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 hallelujah. And I'm not going to say, amen, I'm not going to share with you all of the 259 antonyms to the word mighty, but I would like to share just a few. An antonym is something opposite, amen. If we're looking at the word mighty, we're looking for something opposite than the word mighty, hallelujah. Amen, one of the words is weak. Weak, powerless, feeble, tiny, helpless, small, insignificant, frail, delicate, incapable, ineffective, puny, and unimportant. And that's about 15 or 20 of the 259, amen, that I found there. Hallelujah. Amen. So what is that telling us here, amen, this morning? That mighty men, true mighty men of valor are in the minority. True mighty men of valor are in the minority. Amen. Cowards are a part of the crowd. Amen. There is a list of cowards in the Word of God. Hallelujah. In Numbers chapter 16. In Numbers chapter 16. Hallelujah. These, amen, are some of the first, amen, names of men that were on the catalog of cowards that are in the Word of God. Amen. And they rose up before Moses with certain of the children of Israel, 250 princes of the assembly, famous in the congregation, men of renown. Amen. Who rose up against Moses? Korah, Dathan, Abiram. Amen. Men who were not men that loved Moses, loved their leadership, loved who God had put in charge of them. Amen. No, but Korah, Dathan, and Abiram, amen, were all men that hated Moses. Hallelujah. They hated that he was their leader. They hated that they needed or had to follow him. Hallelujah. So they focused on complaining to anybody that would listen. Amen. And according to that verse of Scripture, they managed to get 250 men to take sides with them. Hallelujah. To take sides with them. Praise God. Hallelujah. These cowards, amen, didn't say anything much until they had a crowd with them. These cowards, they just kind of mixed and mingled within the congregation and with, amen, the assembly, praise God, and amen, and fussed and complained and griped about Moses every which way they could. Amen. They didn't really say anything to Moses' face, amen, until they had a crowd of 250 men standing by their side. Hallelujah. Amen. Then they rose up. Then they caused trouble. Amen. They wanted to lead the nation themselves and not follow Moses. Amen. So they came against Moses. And when they did, the Bible says Moses fell on his face before God. And Moses looked at these men, these 250 men that they had, amen, got to be their crowd and their gang. Amen. So to speak. And Moses said, hallelujah, meet me at the tabernacle tomorrow. And God will decide who the leader is here. So the next day they met. Hallelujah. Verse 28. If you can throw that verse of scripture up there. And Moses said, hereby ye shall know that the Lord has sent me to do all of these works, for I have not done them of mine own mind. Hallelujah. Amen. Moses was basically saying, I don't know what you're complaining about. I don't know what you're fussing about. I didn't want this job in the first place. The only reason I'm here is because God wouldn't let me out of this. I'm not doing this myself. I'm not doing these things myself. Hallelujah. Amen. He said, hereby, amen, you shall know that the Lord has sent me to do all of these works, for I have not done them of mine own mind. So you know what? Hallelujah. That day, the next day, praise God, the earth opened up and swallowed up all of the cowards that were afraid to follow Moses. All of the cowards, their families, their possessions, and everything that they owned in this world, amen, were gone. Hallelujah. I don't know how God done it. Amen. But he opened the ground up, and all of the cowards went down into the pit. Amen. And the earth swallowed them up, the Bible says. Hallelujah. Well, amen, what happened to the 250 men, amen, that had joined sides with them? Amen. Trying to overthrow Moses, trying to take over. Hallelujah. Listen, amen, you better take heed to your listen to who you're listening to today. You better take heed, amen, to who you're paying attention to, whose voices you're tuning into today. Hallelujah. Amen. I just warned somebody today, you don't just need to be listening to anybody. Hallelujah. Verse 35 of number 16 says, and there came out a fire from the Lord and consumed the 250 men that offered incense. Now, we have a list of three men, amen, that we could put in the catalog of cowards, but we don't know the names. Yeah, well, yes, we do know the names. I think we do anyway. Amen. I'm sure they're listed somewhere there in the Word of God, the names of these Jews. Amen. Exactly who they were. Hallelujah. Amen. But some of the first ones on the list of the catalog of cowards, hallelujah. There's many, hallelujah, that we do know in the Word of God, and more that we simply do not know in the Word of God. Did I read verse 35? I'm sorry. All right, I did. Hallelujah. So the 250 got consumed with the fire. Praise God. The Bible says of those 250 men, that they were great men. That they were men that burned incense before the Lord. Hallelujah. They were well-respected men in the congregation. They were men that people looked up to. Hallelujah. But somehow, they allowed, amen, cowards to get to them and pervert their thinking and pervert their minds. Hallelujah, to come against Moses. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm telling you, it didn't work for them, and it won't work for anybody today. Hallelujah. In Numbers chapter 13, Moses sent out 12 spies to see the promised land, 10 spies whose names are listed, amen, in verses 4 through 16 of Numbers chapter 13. Amen. They all belong in the catalog of cowards. 10 spies, amen, who are listed. Their names are there, amen. All of their names, amen, belong in the catalog of cowards. Hallelujah. There were 10 cowards and 2 men of valor. Again, men of valor are in the minority. Hallelujah. Men of valor are certainly the minority. That's why out of hundreds of thousands of men that David had in his armies, he only listed 37 in that chapter. Hallelujah. In 1 Samuel chapter 2, there's Eli, Hophni, and Phinehas, names that need to be added to the catalog of cowards. Hallelujah. Amen. Eli wouldn't do anything to straighten his sons out. Hallelujah. He let them commit adultery with the women at the door of the temple. Amen. He let them do whatever they wanted to do. They burned strange incense before God. They done everything wrong. Amen. Hallelujah. That God had commanded the ministry to do. So Eli, Hophni, and Phinehas, all of their names need to be added to the list. In Nehemiah, there's 3 names that come to mind. I said this went from Joshua to Nehemiah, right? Amen. Let's get the other end of this thing. Nehemiah. Amen. There's 3 names that come to mind. Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem. Hallelujah. These 3 men were not Jews themselves, but they tried to stop the Jews from rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem. Hallelujah. The ones we've got their names, Sanballat, Tobiah, Geshem. The ones that we don't have names for is the Jews that confederated with them. Amen. That sent word to them and kept them up on what was taking place in Jerusalem. Hallelujah. We don't have those men's names. Amen. But those men's names need to be listed to the catalog of cowards. Amen. They were cowards who resisted God. While men of valor held a weapon with one hand, hallelujah, to fight off the enemy, while they, amen, had work tools in another hand, amen, to rebuild, amen, the walls of the city, hallelujah, amen. I'm telling you something this morning. Men of valor know how to fight, amen, and they know how to build this morning. Just a few compared to the thousands who wouldn't fit, who wouldn't lift a finger. Amen. Hallelujah. There's listed in there all of the men that went to work with Ezra and Nehemiah. Hallelujah. Oh, God. They were just a few compared to the thousands who wouldn't lift a finger to the work of God. I got a question to you this morning. Are men born to be men of valor? No, sir. Men are not born from birth to be men of valor. Only through training. Only through experience. Only through hard work. Only through the tenacity to get better and stronger. Amen. Did the men of David strengthen themselves? Hallelujah. Warriors are not warriors. They develop into warriors. Amen. You wasn't born into this world a warrior. You wasn't born into this world a fighter. Amen. You wasn't born into this world a man of valor. Amen. If you have attained such status, it is because you applied yourself. You strengthened yourself. Amen. You trained yourself. Hallelujah. To do right in the face of opposition. Amen. You kept on doing right. When it would have been easier, amen, to do wrong. When it would have been easier, amen, just to forget about any convictions. Anything that you know about God, when it would have been easier just to forget it all. Men of valor stick by their convictions. Stick by what they know, amen, how they know to live and do. Hallelujah. A warrior is not a man without fear. As I talk about men of valor, I don't want you to get the wrong impression this morning. Amen. Men of valor are not men without fears, but a man who refuses to let his fears paralyze him. A warrior, a man of valor, is somebody that refuses to let fear paralyze him. Hallelujah. A man who fights through his fears. Can a man who has been a man of valor go back and become a coward again? Of course they can. Hallelujah. We've got a perfect example. Amen. King Saul is the example of that. Saul started out a great king. Amen. A great military leader. Amen. But something happened to Saul. Sin changed him. 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 11. Let's read it. When Saul and all of Israel heard those words of the Philistines, amen, they were dismayed and greatly afraid. Yeah, we're talking about the king of Israel here. We're talking about the king of the greatest army, amen, that, hallelujah, that has ever marched together, praise God, to a battlefield. Hallelujah, we've got, amen, we've got a king here, amen, who is totally dismayed and afraid of the Philistine army. Sin changed him from being a great king, a great military leader, into being a coward. Saul had managed to produce not only cowardship in himself, amen, but a whole army of cowards. Hallelujah, they were over there on their hill digging trenches, digging ditches. The first time it's ever mentioned in the Word of God that Israel took time to dig trenches. They, amen, their warfare they thought was going to become trench warfare. Amen, Israel didn't know how to fight trench warfare. Amen, they were used to going on the battlefield as men of war and fighting and winning the battles and then going home with the spoils. Amen, but Saul had managed to produce a whole army of cowards, including all of David's brothers. Amen, but then David shows up and inspires them. Hallelujah, they get their eyes off of Saul and they get their eyes on this little, amen, young Rudy lad. Amen, as he makes his, amen, trek down the hillside out to the valley. Amen, to fight a giant. Amen, to prove that, hey, there's no giant big enough to defy the armies of the living God. Hallelujah, it's important who inspires you. Hallelujah, don't let Saul inspire you. Don't let a coward inspire you. You'll become a coward yourself. Be inspired by men of faith. Be inspired, amen, by men that are fearless of going to the battlefield. Amen. We all need some positive influences on our lives. In John chapter 6 and verse 66, there were 70 men in that verse. Amen. 70 men that deserted the army of the Lord all at one time. 70 disciples walked away from Jesus because they didn't like what he said that day. Hallelujah. Their names need to be added to the catalog of cowards. They walked away. Amen. When they walked away, Jesus turned and looked at his 12 and he said, "Will you go also? You're going to leave me too? I just watched 70 disciples walk away. Are you 12 going to walk away too?" Amen. And Peter was the one that replied, "To whom shall we go? Where can we go? We have nowhere else to turn but to you, Lord." Hallelujah. But out of that 12, there was one that betrayed him. Out of the 12, there was one that betrayed him. There were 70 that we don't know their names. But there was one that we do know, and his name was Judas. And Judas was a coward. Why was Judas a coward? How was he converted, amen, from being a chosen elect, amen, apostle of the Lord to becoming a coward? Hallelujah. Because he allowed Satan to enter into his heart again. Amen. The list goes on and on and on and on this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But you're sitting here listening to me this morning thinking, well, what does all that have to do with us? Let me tell you something. It has a lot to do with us. Here we are this morning at church. We're all dressed up. Amen. You got all pretty. You got clean. You took a shower. You combed your hair. You put your deodorant on. You put your, amen, cologne on. You came to church looking pretty and smelling good. Amen. But you came because you wanted to be here. Hallelujah. You came because you wanted to sing and shout and dance and run and worship. Amen. I hope that you came because you wanted to hear the preacher preach. Hallelujah. I hope you came to hear what I got to say today. Amen. Hallelujah. So here we are in the house of God. But my question is this morning, why did God choose us? Why did God take time out for us? Why did God call our name? Amen. Why did God deal with us? Why are we here? Why are we here this morning? Amen. In the house of God, loving Him, serving Him, worshiping Him this morning. Hallelujah. Why did God choose us? Well, I'll tell you one reason that He didn't choose us. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 26, the Bible says, "For you see your calling, brethren." All right, we're looking at why God called us, right? Amen. "How that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called." I didn't mean to sink your boat. I didn't mean to knock the wind out of your sails. But you didn't get to church because you were smart. God didn't choose you to serve Him, amen, because you were smart. Amen. God didn't choose you to serve Him because you were mighty or noble or somebody special. No, we wasn't special. No, we wasn't smart. We wasn't mighty. We wasn't noble. You know what we all were? Oh, yeah. It's going to come home now. You know what we all were? We were all cowards. Whoa, I didn't know it'd go over that heavy. We were all cowards that got scared. We got scared of the direction that our life was taking us in. Amen. We got scared of going to hell. Amen. We got scared of dying and facing eternity. Amen. Without knowing what was awaiting on us. Amen. Before the judgment seat of God. We got scared, hallelujah, of the direction of life that we were going in. We got scared that we would end up in a devil's hell for eternity. I was a coward. I got scared of becoming an alcoholic, of becoming a drug addict, amen, or dying from lung cancer. I got scared of losing my wife. I got scared of losing my kids. I got scared of losing my mind. I was a coward. Brother Barfield, I was a coward. Hallelujah. Amen. I was a coward and you were a coward. Hallelujah. I got scared of going to hell one day. Hallelujah. I was a coward. My name was on the list of the catalog of cowards. My name was there alongside, amen, a lot of other names that were there. Praise God. I was a coward. But I was a coward that got concerned. I was a coward that got scared of going to hell. Hallelujah. I didn't know my name was on that list, but now I know. God don't call many noble folks. God don't call many mighty folks. Hallelujah. God don't call many wise folks. Hallelujah. So it wasn't my smartness that got me here. It wasn't my mightiness that got me here. It wasn't nobility that I had been born with a name, amen, that God had to pay special attention to. But I was a coward who was willing to cry out to God for help. I was a coward that got so scared of where my life was headed that I was willing to cry out for help. The Bible says a contrite spirit and a broken heart, God cannot turn away. I was scared, and I was sick and tired of being scared. And God heard this coward's cry. God heard this coward when he cried out for help. God heard this coward, Hallelujah. When he realized he couldn't make it on his own, that he had to have help, that he had to have a Savior, that he had to have a deliverer, that he had to have somebody on his side. He couldn't make it alone. So God heard this coward's prayer, and he called me to serve him. Hallelujah. Amen. Was I a mighty man of valor? No, 1,000 times no. But when God called my name, he was giving me a chance to change. Hallelujah. Amen. He was giving me a chance to change who I was and what I was. Hallelujah. I was a coward needing a change. Hallelujah. He must have seen a willingness. Amen. In me to do whatever had to be done. Amen. For me to be saved. Hallelujah. He must have seen the same things in you. He must have seen you get to a place, amen, that you were willing to do whatever you had to do to be saved. And that's exactly where we have to get to. Amen. We've got to be willing to say yes to God. We've got to be willing to say whatever you want from me, God. Amen. Whatever you have me to do, God. Amen. I will do it. Hallelujah. Amen. And when we get to that place, God can change a coward. Yes, he can. Hallelujah. David's mighty men of valor, they didn't start out that way. You hear me? They didn't start out that way. Am I getting too long-winded here this morning? Hallelujah. David's mighty men of valor, they didn't start out that way. They found inspiration in David. Amen. And the Bible says that they strengthened themselves along beside him. Hallelujah. Amen. They watched him. They imitated him. They walked after him. They did what he did. They strengthened themselves. Hallelujah. You and I are here today because we found, amen, inspiration in God. Inspiration in the Word of God. Somebody got up one day and preached a message, amen, that drilled us, amen, to the core. Hallelujah. That was right where we were living. Amen. And God began to talk to us. Job 32 and verse 8 says, but there's a spirit of man, and the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them in understanding. There's a spirit in man, and the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them understanding. I didn't have no understanding until I surrendered to the Spirit of God. I didn't understand nothing. Hallelujah. Thank God. But thank God this coward came to understand that he needed God one day. God didn't start his army by choosing military geniuses. David's men didn't start out being men of valor. They trained and became men of valor. God didn't start his army, amen, with men of valor. Hallelujah. He didn't start out with geniuses. Huh? Now you may be sitting here thinking you're a genius. And you may be. But there ain't many of them called. Hallelujah. So he started picking us up. He started picking us up off the bottom. He couldn't find many mighty, couldn't find many noble, couldn't find many wise that would submit to him. So what did he do? Amen. He started reaching down to the bottom, to where you and I were. If y'all come get a little song ready here. He reached down to the bottom and he started molding us, started working with us, started calling us, started dealing with us. Amen. He started working with us. Hallelujah. I remember night after night after night after night after night after night, amen, of not sleeping because the Spirit of God was dealing with me when I was sinning. Hallelujah. Amen. Conviction was on me. Amen. Hard. Hallelujah. Heavy. Amen. Conviction was on my life. Hallelujah. Amen. God was reaching all the way down to the bottom to where I was at. Amen. Because he had a vision for me. He had hope for me. He wanted to mold me. Amen. He wanted to make me into, amen, what I wasn't at that day. Hallelujah. Amen. God didn't start by thinking we qualified to be on his special forces team. But when I repented and when I got baptized and I received the baptism of the Holy Ghost, hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to tell you what God did for me. Amen. God took my name. When I repented, got baptized, and received the Holy Ghost, God took my name off of the catalog of cowards. Hallelujah. And he put my name, and hopefully he put your name this morning, hallelujah, on his catalog of mighty men. I'm not just talking to men this morning. I'm talking about mighty men, mighty women, mighty young people, mighty children this morning. Hallelujah. His catalog of mighty men in the book of Revelation chapter 21 and verse 27, I believe it is called the Lamb's Book of Life. So when I did all of that, God took my name off of the catalog of cowards and he put my name on his list. His list, the Lamb's Book of Life. A list that contains many mighty men, women, boys, and girls. Amen. Not because we had reached that status back then, but because he knew that what we would become, amen, as long as we were inspired by him. God saw something in us that we didn't even see ourselves. So I come to you this morning by faith. I come to you today by faith. I feel like by faith I am speaking to mighty men, women, and children this morning. Because of the examples of men like Saul and Judas and others, we know that if we do not strengthen ourselves in God by doing what we know to do and trying to get better at what we do, we can fall back into being a coward again. If we quit trying, if we quit putting our heart into living for God, it's not impossible to get back on that list again. But let me say this morning, there's no time left for that. Time is running out, folks. Time is near. The Lord is soon to come. There's no time for us being in and out of church, up and down. Amen. With the victory one day, defeated the next day, in and out, up and down, in and out, up and down. Hallelujah. Amen. It's time, amen, for everybody, amen, to once and for all conquer that. I want you to close your eyes and say, I'm not a coward. I'm not a coward. I'm not going to be a coward. I'm not going to allow the enemy to put my name back on that catalog of cowards. There's no time left for us to play games in God. Amen. Today, David's mighty men might be called the Navy SEALs if they were American soldiers. They may be among the Navy SEALs. They may be among the Green Berets. They may be among the Delta Special Forces, amen, that are sent in on special, amen, missions to conquer enemies that feel like they can never be conquered. I want you and I to be classified as God's special forces. I want Higher Praise Tabernacle to be a body of men and women, boys and girls, an outfit, a group, a platoon, whatever we want to call ourselves. I want us to be a group, a body of believers that God can look at and consider us a part of his special forces this morning. Hallelujah. Remember, being mighty men and women of God doesn't mean that you won't have fear, but it does mean that you won't allow your fears to paralyze you and put you on the sidelines. Fighting the good fight of faith is what I have from here on out. That's what's challenging me. And that's what needs to be challenging you. We need to be making up our mind. I'm going to be a soldier in the army of the Lord, and I'm going to fight the good fight of faith. Amen. From today till the day that I draw my last breath. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Every time I look into the mirror, every time I look into the mirror, I am reminded that age has a factor. time I look into that mirror. I looked into the mirror to tie my tie in my office. And I couldn't help but to just look and shake my head. What was you looking at, Brother Morales? I was looking at wrinkles on top of other wrinkles. I was looking at these bags under my eyes with these little circles. Man, I look like a raccoon. I don't even know how y'all sit here looking. I don't even know how y'all sit here and listen to a raccoon preach to y'all every Sunday. I got these bags and these circles and wrinkles on top of wrinkles. Boy, age is a factor, right? Age is a factor, right? I see age spots. Yeah, I got them. I can see that time does change things. I'm not as young as I used to be. I was young, and now I'm old, the scripture says. I'm not the young man that I used to be. I'm not a man full of zeal and zest the way that I one time was. I'm not as young as it used to be. But I do realize, amen, that I started out life with not with my name on that list right there. And that changed when I was born again of the water and of the Spirit. My name has been transferred off of that list over to the Lamb's list. Hallelujah. But I want to say to you this morning, it's not my intention. It's not my intention. I don't even entertain the thoughts of going back on God. Because time is running out. Time is quickly moving along in my life. Hallelujah. I don't know how much more time I got left. Amen. But one way or another, I'm going to take the dirt nap. Amen. In the future, praise God. Hallelujah. If God spares us all and the rapture trumpet sounds and we're all caught up, I'll be happy with that. But if that don't happen, amen, 20 years, 25 years, I don't know. I'm going to pass from this life to eternity. Amen. And when I do that, I want to know of a surety that I'm going to be able to stand before the Lord and hear the words, enter in, enter in, enter in. My good and faithful servant, if you'd stand to your feet this morning to help me to hush. I feel good. I feel the Lord. I feel a deep stirring in my soul. I feel the deep calling to the deep this morning. Hallelujah. I feel that I have presented a challenge to somebody this morning. I feel like I'm challenging somebody here today. Hallelujah. To stand up, stand tall, stand strong. Hallelujah. Amen. Be who you have been called to be. Amen. Be what God has called you to be. Don't let the voices of this world and the influences of this world convince you that you have time to go out and play around in sin. That you have time to go out and dibble and dabble, amen, in the things of this world. No, you don't have time. And no, none of us have time for that. Hallelujah. So I'm just challenging you this morning. Hallelujah. Amen. If you have drifted away, if you've drawn away because, amen, of the lust of your flesh, hallelujah, that you shake yourself, that you stir yourself, and you be challenged by this message this morning to get back in the army of God, get back on the front lines, and to be everything that God called you to be. God is looking for a few good men, a few good women, a few good young people, hallelujah, amen, that will make up their mind that they're going to be all that they can be in God. You know why? Amen, because they in return can inspire others. This is all about soul winning, people. If you live for God the way that you're supposed to live for God, then you can be a soul winner. If you dabble in sin, if you're in and out, up and down, confused, then you're not going to ever convince anybody to serve your God. You got to get in with a made up mind. I want us to lift your hand to the Lord this morning and pray together as they sing a little song. Father, Lord God, Lord, you know, God, you know, God, you laid this message on my heart. I couldn't get away from it. I tried to escape it, God, but you wouldn't allow me. So I've done my best to present it as best I could. It's up to you now, God. It's up to you now, God. It's up to you, God, to convince that weary mind, that wearied heart, that troubled spirit who has allowed things to come between you and them. It's up to you, God, to draw them back to your side. Before it's too late, before they've gone too far, before they've messed up so bad that they cannot be fixed, while they are still in that fixable situation, God, I'm asking you to fix minds and hearts, spirits and souls here today. God, fix them, God. Today, hallelujah. God, I'm asking you to fix that broken heart. Fix, amen, that wounded spirit. Fix that wounded mind, soul today, hallelujah. Oh, God, let the power of the Holy Ghost begin to move and begin to touch. Oh, God, hallelujah, Jesus. Of valor this morning. Brave and strong, hallelujah. Brave and strong. Faithful and true, God, hallelujah. Oh, come on, somebody, you can pray. Come on, somebody, you can pray. Hallelujah, you can find your way back to God. You can find what you need in God. God can touch you right where you're sitting. God can touch you right where you are standing. He can renew you. He can restore you. If you'll just make up your mind, God. I don't want to be a coward. I simply don't want to be a coward. I want to be a man of valor, a woman of valor, a young person of valor. Hallelujah, Jesus. He did it all, my shy God. Oh, listen to the words. This world don't have anything for you. This world don't have anything for us. Oh, God, I'm reaching. Hallelujah. I don't want to end right now. I'm reaching for somebody. Hallelujah. If you're watching online this morning and God is dealing with your heart, hallelujah, get your name off of the catalog of cowards and find your way to the house of God. Find your way to God. Find your way to a place, hallelujah, that you can be, amen, listed on the catalog of mighty men, women, boys, and girls. To an altar, find your way to a place to repent. Jesus,
come to my rescue.
Oh, Jesus.
Where else can I?
Almighty God.
There's no other name by which I am saved.
Jesus.
Capture me with grace.
I was asked before I came to the pulpit to preach, brother asked me, he said, you think you got a message from God? And I responded to that question by saying, I hope I do. I hope I do. But I want to change that response. I know with full assurance that God gave me this message for this service. I don't just hope I got a message. I know I got a message. Amen, because God don't want anybody here going to hell. Amen. God don't want anybody here going to hell. So I'm throwing out a lifeline. Amen. Get it fixed. Get it fixed. Get it fixed. Get it fixed right quickly. Get it fixed. Make it right. Get it fixed. Get back where you need to be in God. Strengthen yourself in the house of God. Strengthen yourself by fellowshipping with brothers and sisters in the Lord. Get away from the voices. Get away from the voices that want to drag you down and make a coward out of you. Get back to where you need to be in God. Lord, I'm praying for those in the sanctuary today that need above anything else, God, to hear exactly what I'm saying today, God. I'm praying for them, God, that they will receive this with humble spirits, that they will receive this message today with teachable spirits, and that they would learn, hallelujah, everything that they need to do, that they need to do it for you. And they need to do it honorably, respectfully, and with great zeal. Bring them back, God. Touch them today, God. We give you all the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Oh, I feel the Lord. I hate to dismiss the service, but I guess it's quite time. This side over here is dismissed. The section on the right is dismissed. We ask you to exit the building as quickly as you can. Don't stand around inside. Talk. Fellowship in here. If you got a fellowship...